So let us look into Flume architecture and then different implementations of Flume agents. And for that, let me go to the material. Flume user guide 1.6.0. And this is the architecture as we have seen already. There will be agent. The agent will have three components: source, channel, and sync. Source is the one which will be reading data from some sort of source. Sync will be writing to some sort of target, which such as HDFS. And channel is to communicate between source and sync in reliable and sustainable fashion. And that being said, if you go to the Ambari and if you try to watch the installation of Flume. So when the setup is done, there will be only Flume client which will be installed wherever we want. Okay, which means the binaries will be deployed. There won't be any daemon process such as HDFS and yarn. HDFS will have data nodes and worker nodes, and masters will have name node. Yarn will have node managers on worker node, and master will have resource managers, so on and so forth. With respect to Flume, there will be no such daemon process that will be running. So whenever we launch Flume, we will be launching on gateway node, nodes like gateway node, which is not part of the cluster by running daemon process, but just to deploy the jobs. So that's why we are connecting to gateway node and launching the scoop jobs. Okay, if you recollect the way I have demonstrated, I have been connecting to this gateway node. And then I have deployed the configuration files under this location. And then I have started agent from here, like this, with agent name as WH and then the configuration file. Okay, this is how the Flume agents will be started on nodes such as gateway node, which are primarily to used to deploy the jobs. That's it. Okay, that being said, now let us get on to different implementations of Flume agents. Predominantly, there are three types. One is multi-agent, two is consolidation, and the three multiplexing. And to understand those things, you need to go to the documentation once again. And if you scroll down, here they have highlighted these different implementations. Okay, multi-agent means output of one agent will be passed as input to the other agent. So the sync of one agent will be integrated with source of another agent. And typically, to set up this multi-agent flow, where output of one agent will be passed as input for another agent, is done by Avro sync and Avro source, because Avro have the capability of RPC, remote procedure calls. There will be a web service that will be running, where the data will be pushed to that web service, and from there the source will be reading. So multi-agent flow means it's a linear flow where we will have multiple agents, and output of one agent will be passed to other agent as input. And then consolidation. If you think about it, we are reading from access.log, which is nothing but a simulated log file where the business data is captured. There's only one such file running on one node. But in typical scenario, in a real scenario, if you think about Amazon or Flipkart or any other top-notch e-commerce websites, there will be multiple web servers or application servers. And the reason for multiple web servers or application servers will be for load balancing, scalability, fault tolerance, so on and so forth. Okay. So it is often required to read data from multiple web server logs, not just one. That's where consolidation will come into picture. If you have three web server logs, there'll be three agents which will be reading from the web server log supporting the same application. But the data have to be consolidated so that we can process data downstream without much issues. And for that, there will be another agent which will be working as a consolidator from all the other three agents in this picture. And then this consolidation, the agent which consolidated the data will write into sync such as HDFS. Again, this consolidation includes that multi-agent flow. This is the use case even for the multi-agent flow. We have first set of agents which will read data from web servers and write into Avro sync. And from the Avro sync, there will be agent which will be reading the data and passing to HDFS. Here the sync need not be Avro sync. It's misleading. It can be just a sync, and that sync can write to HDFS. It's a bug bug in the documentation. Here the sync shouldn't be Avro sync. It has to be sync. Okay. So that is about consolidation, and we will be seeing that in most of the applications where there will be multiple web server logs from which data has to be retrieved. And then multiplexing. So if you have one source and if you try to write data to multiple syncs, then we have multiplexing. Okay, and we will be implementing this as we proceed further, as we understand more about Kafka and streaming analytics and all those things. Our final outcome will be multiplexing, where there'll be one source which is nothing but web server logs, and then two targets, one HDFS, and two, we will perform Spark streaming and store it back to HDFS. Okay, so we'll be storing raw data to HDFS and also processed data to HDFS. That way, if there are any issues with our data, we have the raw data in HDFS itself, we can reconcile easily. Okay, so, and it is a very typical use case in real world. And that being said, there will be two things ultimately by the time we complete this course. One, we will be writing raw data to HDFS directly, and another will be writing to Spark streaming, and that Spark streaming will process the data and store it back to HDFS. Okay, and whenever you have a sync, there has to be an associated channel with it. One channel cannot write to multiple syncs. That is not possible. Whenever you have a sync, there will be associated with channel associated with it. So one source can write into multiple syncs, and each sync has to have a channel. So ultimately, in our pursuit of writing raw data to HDFS and processed data through Spark streaming to HDFS, we'll have two syncs. There will be two channels associated with it, and there will be only one source, which is nothing but web server logs. That is about multiplexing, and multiplexing is also extensively used in real world scenarios. Okay, so these are the three different implementations of Flume agents. And the first one is multi-agent flow, second one is consolidation, and third one is multiplexing. And quite often these are mixed together to implement the streaming data ingestion or streaming analytics as part of the applications. Okay, so that being said, now let us move on to next topic.